However, Paul continues in verse 10. He says, if it should happen at any time that Timothy would go towards you, then you must observe. So he's letting them know that even if Paul himself doesn't go to Corinth at this particular time, then perhaps Timothy will go towards them. And he says, whenever Timothy will go, you must observe. Be mentally aware. Contemplate in your minds. And that word also refers to the fact that they may not physically see something with their eyes, but they must observe, be mentally aware. Why? For the purpose and result that he will fearlessly come to pass to be towards or with you. And that would be in a manner that he is without fear of any consequences of the performance of wrong behavior. Because in truth, he, Timothy, is working. Timothy is expending his energy. Timothy is producing effects by his actions. What work is he doing? In truth, he is working the Lord's work. Timothy was working the works of the Lord Jesus Christ. The action of expending energy in what he was doing was originating from the Lord Jesus Christ. What Timothy was doing and accomplishing was in alignment. It was in harmony and agreement with the Lord Jesus Christ. Just as I am, Paul writes. So he was likening Timothy to himself insofar as Paul also was working the Lord's work. Following on logically, let not someone despise him. So Paul is telling the Corinthian holy people, and of course this is by way of a polite command or a very strong suggestion, let not somebody. So any of the Corinthian holy people that were there should not be treating Timothy as though he were nothing, thinking less of him, treating him with contempt, setting him as naught. But all of you must send him forward on his journey in peace. Send him forward on his journey as he's progressing, doing his own traveling arrangements in peace within the sphere of action of tranquil harmony. Send him forth with peaceful wholeness without any strife or disagreement. For the purpose and result that he would go towards me. For I am waiting for him. Paul was letting them know that he was waiting for Timothy to arrive back to his own location there in Ephesus. I am waiting for him in company and association with the brothers, with the other holy people who were with Paul at this time. They were waiting for Timothy to come back to them. In verse 12, Paul continues, and he says now about the topic of Apollos, concerning Apollos, who is the brother of all of you. So Paul is letting them know that Apollos is also a brother. Apollos also has received that gift of Holy Spirit within him. He is a son of God and a brother of every other holy person. Concerning Apollos the brother, I encouraged him with many things. Paul says, I exhorted him. I called him beside myself, as a concerned father or mother would call their children towards themselves, so as to help him to do what's right. And Paul says what he was encouraging him regarding. He says, for the purpose and result that he would go towards you in company and association with the brothers. And it was not at all his intention. During that past time, Paul lets them know that it was not Apollos' will that he would go to you at that time, but he will go to you at whatever time he will have good opportunity. So Paul was letting them know that Apollos will go back to them. He will visit them at a specific occasion that it will be well with Apollos. Then at that time, Apollos will go to Corinth. In verses 13 and 14, Paul continues to teach the holy people regarding how they should walk, how they should behave and conduct themselves during the everyday living of their lives as they were awaiting the return of the Lord Jesus Christ from heaven to gather all of us together with him in the air. Paul writes, "You must wakefully watch," or "it is imperative that you are watchful, keep or stay awake." And of course, this figuratively refers to being alert in the spirit category. Keep your eyes open. Be spiritually aware and sensitive to what the Holy Spirit may want to reveal to you. God, by means of the Lord Jesus Christ and the Spirit within, can communicate, can contribute information to all holy people. And so Paul is letting them know that they should keep awake, wakefully watch, be alert, be sensitive to the Spirit working within them. And you must stand firm. Stand fast as opposed to falling. Of course, this is regarding their walk and behavior. Stand fast in what? In the belief. That is, within the sphere of action of the belief or the faith. That information that God has given to be believed. Stand fast on it. And that would include the information that Paul has written about here throughout the book of 1 Corinthians. He has already talked about what to believe. He's talked about the gift of Holy Spirit. He's talked about resurrection. He's talked about the hope of the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul also writes, "You must render yourselves as adult males, as grown men." Grown men behaving themselves in light of God's word. "You must be strong." And that word strong refers to having strength or power in effect. Exert that strength, doing the will of the Lord according to the Spirit working within you. "All your things must come to pass in love." And Paul talked a lot regarding love, godly love, that agape kind of love in chapter 13 of this book of 1 Corinthians. All of your things, everything that you do during the everyday living of your lives must come to pass, must happen, must occur within the sphere of action of godly love. Paul continues in verse 15.